Chocolate is well known for its fine flavor and its history began in ancient times when the Maya civilization considered chocolate a cocoa drink prepared with hot water, the food of the gods. Hi, I'm Dr. Radha and I'm here to talk about everybody's favorite, chocolate. Starting from cocoa beans to various processes of transformation, the food industry produces different types of chocolate with defined ingredients and characteristics. The first one, dark chocolate, contains cocoa bean solids up to 80% of the total weight and cocoa butter. With the intense and persistent aroma of cocoa, it melts in the mouth, leaving a pleasant bitter aftertaste. Its quality depends on the percentage of cocoa. Most of the health benefits attributable to chocolate are associated with consuming the dark type. The second, Gianduja chocolate, is a combination of hazelnuts, cocoa and sugar. It is brown. The third, milk chocolate, contains cocoa butter, sugar, milk powder, lecithin and cocoa not less than 20 to 25%. With a bright appearance, it has an intense, persistent aroma and sweet taste with a slightly bitter taste of cocoa. Fourth, white chocolate, contains cocoa butter, milk and sugar with no cocoa solids. It has a sweet, pleasant taste. Cocoa, the basic ingredient in chocolate, contains a significant amount of fat, which is about 40 to 55% as cocoa butter, with approximately 33% oleic acid, 25% palmitic acid, and 33% stearic acid. Cocoa bean is one of the best known sources of dietary polyphenols, containing more phenolic antioxidants than most foods, which constitutes about 10% of the whole bean's dry weight. Three groups of polyphenols, which are most abundant phytonutrients identified in cocoa beans, are catechins 37%, anthocyanins 4%, and proanthocyanins 58%. It is well known that polyphenols in cocoa are associated with beneficial effects. However, the bitterness caused by polyphenols makes unprocessed cocoa bean rather unpalatable. Manufacturers have therefore developed processing techniques for eliminating the bitterness. Such processes decrease the polyphenol content by up to tenfold, and for consumers, the product is markedly different, mainly owing to the low polyphenol content. And substances like sugar, emulsifiers such as soy lecithin, added during the processing phase. Cocoa contains both proteins and methyl xanthins like theobromine and caffeine, in addition to being a rich source of minerals like potassium, phosphorus, copper, iron, zinc and magnesium. Therefore, only dark chocolate with high percentage of cocoa of about 70 to 80%, flavonoids and theobromine and low content of sugar would be associated with health promoting effects, including prevention of cardiovascular diseases. Similarly, cocoa induces positive effects on blood pressure, insulin resistance, and vascular function. It increases the production of nitric oxide and has antioxidant effects with delayed oxidation of low-density lipoprotein cholesterol and inhibiting ultraviolet-induced DNA oxidation. A single blind randomized placebo-controlled crossover study showed that after 4 weeks, negative metabolic effects of raised fasting insulin, insulin resistance, and salivary cortisol in subjects consuming 20 grams per day dark chocolate with negligible polyphenol content, but not in those consuming same amount of polyphenol rich 500 milligrams of chocolate. Therefore, Martin points out that consumption of small quantities of flavanols from cocoa or chocolate is beneficial. However, Ramis mentions that most commercial available soluble cocoa products are chocolate containing low amount of flavanols and are rich in sugar and calories. Therefore, high consumption of chocolate will induce paradoxical consequences like weight gain, impaired glucose homeostasis, and type 2 diabetes mellitus. In recent years, there has been growing interest in the study of intestinal microbiota and its changes as a result of a particular diet. Tizonis et al. Concluded that the intake of 494 milligrams of cocoa flavonoids per day for 4 weeks had a significant effect on intestinal microbiota growth. Cocoa in chocolate acts as a functional food since it contributes to a number of substances that show beneficial health effects. Chocolate extends its effects on some organoleptic characteristics along with antidepressant properties. A point of caution that needs to be stressed is that several studies evaluated the health promoting properties of cocoa and not chocolate itself. So, the role of cocoa on human health cannot be completely compared to that of a chocolate. Despite availability of a number of in vitro and experimental reports, epidemiological studies, there is still scarce data on the beneficial effects of dark chocolate. One should keep in mind the presence of a number of co-founders like other diet components, lifestyle, environmental exposures, exact consumption of chocolate, chocolate composition, duration of observation, and other risk factors when claiming the benefits of cocoa or chocolate. Chocolate manufacturers do not have to report the flavanol content of their products. As a result, it is difficult to know how much dark chocolate a person would need to maximize its health benefits. In conclusion, people who are interested in adding dark chocolate to their diets should keep in mind that it is high in fat and calories. So, moderation is the key. Thank you.